bury twice a day. And truly that is the stuff of nightmares. The story goes that Marjorie McCall died from a fever in 1725. Her husband tried to remove her wedding ring, but was on so tight that she had to be buried with it. Later that night, three robbers dug her up and tried to remove the ring. When they couldn't, they decided to cut off her finger. But Marjorie came to life and confronted the petrified wooden thieves.
This one has the damage of the whole family and many pensions. People who are maybe from a generation that are more willing to trust and take people at face value and not think that, you know, this is going to happen to them.
Edith's family are yet to receive any of their rightful inheritance. But once they do, it will be shared fairly between the people who loved her most and who wish for Edith to be remembered as the remarkable woman she was, and not for the crime committed against her.
I want the warnings remembered. I want people to be aware of what can happen. But I also want Edith to be remembered as this beautiful, wonderful, kind lady with this twinkle in her eye who called everyone a darling.
What happened to Edith is a stark warning for us all to be increasingly vigilant when seeking care for our elderly relatives. Now, fortunately, the majority of people out there are perfectly trustworthy and reliable. Julie Sales was found guilty of 8 counts of fraud. When passing sentence, the judge made clear that Julie's offences were the worst kind of dishonesty. Because, of course, they were a profound breach of trust. Not only had Julie taken close to £300,000, she had deliberately targeted a vulnerable victim. She was sentenced to 9 years behind bars. Now, all offences of dishonesty are to be taken seriously by the court, but where a person breaches such a fundamental trust, in this case, the carer and her patient, sentences are quite rightly extremely severe.
Looking at how policemen's helmets and lava lamps came to be, we've made in Britain over on ITV4 next. Stay with us here for Secrets and Lies, as Brenda Blethyn stars as the formidable Vera. Sponsored by Patient Claim Line, medical negligence specialists.
Dad, is the legend of the jungle really true?
Yes.
So, being buried in...
VPN, your shield from online snoopers. Download and enjoy trusted internet security and privacy.
Click to join a week worrying about how much time you've got left.
Regular client?
No, it's
that
phone.
Did you find the agency?
until the end of the year.
In your original statement, you said you didn't see the man's face.
That's right.
Well, what did you see? Was he short, tall, black, white?
He was white, and the only other thing I remember was his leather jacket. It was nice. Expensive.
When did you hear about the report?
2 days later on the report.
But you didn't come forward then?
No. In that line of work.
To reopen the investigation. Of lazy palms for a pound. I thought it was the most wonderful gesture. I trusted him. The best man at the wedding, so I signed the papers. I found out later that on the day of Dean's funeral, Mike had mortgaged the lot. And once it was all unraveled, there were just debts, not assets. About 2 million quid's worth. So it completely wiped me out. So, thanks to Mike's creative accounting, I'm stuck here in Gamma's Kingdom. What made you decide to leave?
The witness came forward. She said she saw a man trying to barge into the house the night that Dean died.
The original police report, it said that he spent the night with your mother. That's right. She was sick. Come home the next morning, whatever.
Yes.
You can't see the front door from the street, so she must be on the ground, won't she? Please, I need to know.
The witness was asking.
She was in the
Scott. DCI Barney Morris. Can we make this quick? I need to be back on the street in half an hour. The crackheads will start wondering where I am.
You're on your
own. What do you think? Listen, before we start, I just want to say, you're wasting your time with him. He shot himself. He knows it's
maybe
you are. It's something. You know the cash funds? Yeah, well, then you'll know where you're through. We looked into his finances, to his personal life, into his movements before he died. All we came up with was rich bloke, loved his wife, but also never forgot where he came from.
What do you mean, never forgot where he came from?
Well, he left a few drinks in the pub in the East End the night before he died.
A rotten piece.
That's the one. Well, Peter's a little bit of a dump, you know. It's 2 feet away from where he was born. If you want to look at the old manor before he topped himself. Trust me, it's a wild goose chase, there's nothing there.
You never found out about the
names.
That's another public transport. Good job you've got your bus pass then.
Oh, thank you very much. Last time I was on a bus, something over me, I see. Who needs that kind of respect? And when I turned her down, she pointed to the sign saying, give it up to the elderly, and then called me a miserable old git.
Yes, Adrian Osler. Timeshare owner with previous. He shoots, he scores!
I've checked that list against the PNC.
Okay, so what have we found?
We have one match, Albert, a disgruntled timeshare owner who was held in contempt of court and issued a caution for assault.
Hardly Britain's most wanted.
Well, the contempt arose during a case against Dean Scott. Adrian Osler sued him for emotional distress, then became abusive when lost and punched his solicitor.
Good, sounds promising. Hurry up, Billy.
Thanks for your help.
That was ballistics.
And?
Blood splatter patterns indicate that Dean was fairly low to the ground when the trigger was pulled.
Well, he was kneeling when he shot himself.
Or he was on his knees, begging for his life.
Maybe Mike Barnes used to borrow a couple of million against a timeshare resort, but Dean refused and he killed him.
The original inquiry checked with immigration. Barnes wasn't in the country on the night.
He slipped in under the radar.
Bump someone off, that's the smart thing.
Well, you're going to be a property millionaire seminar tomorrow. I want you and Jerry on your property.
I always wanted to hear what those property gurus have got to say.
Mr. Osler?
Yeah, we're from the Met. We need to talk to you about Dean Scott.
Well, nothing to say about him,
but you did in court.
You said, and I quote, he ruined my life.
What's it matter now?
He shot himself and my life's still crap. End of story.
So tell us why you hated him so much.
Well, let me see. Oh, yeah. My wife divorced me. I lost my job. Then I went bankrupt.
It wasn't all his fault,
wasn't it? Listen, we bought one of these crappy timeshare villas on our honeymoon, which is ironic because 6 years later, my lovely wife was by the pool when one the waiter turned up with a pina colada and ended our marriage. So she ran off with one.
Yeah. They took me to the cleaners. She got the house, the car, the savings. Guess what I did?
Timeshare villa. Bingo. But by the way, no one was interested in it. So I could never be surprised. Then when I defaulted on a rip-off service charge, the Lord of Lands had brought me and said the baby's from it. And I made it. And that's when I went to get Nala. Got me 345 and ended up bankrupt. So do me a favour. Don't tell me it wasn't his fault, but I know that it was.
So he took Dean to court.
He's either that or kill myself.
But you lost the case, and a year later he was dead.
Every cloud has a silver lining.
Because the other half of me wants to show the cocky.
Alzheimer's.